Today, I want to share with you 5 different types of falsy lashes, and let's pick the best falsies on my eye shape. Let's understand my eye shape first. I have a round, stubby, and smaller eyelid compared to other nationality,
like Caucasian, Indian, Vietnamese, Black, and Filipino. They are so much bigger and wider eye shape than me.
Obviously, they look better with falsy, but I have my own way to show you what looks good on this eye shape. I bet a lot of people have the same problem as me. There's 5 different types. It will be dramatic to very classic.
I want to share with you, once you find your own color and identity, you will shine through so much better. Okay, let's not talk too much. Let's go right now, shall we?
Let's go from dramatic to classic. This is magnetic lashes.
Ugh. This is magnetic lashes.
Very dramatic and long. And this is dramatic and very full volume. And this is wispy and volume. Slightly short, still volume and fluffy.
And the last?
General, classic.
You need to do eyeliner and mascara first.
I use Kat Von D eyeliner. I've been using it for 3 years now. I never changed to anything else because this is so awesome.
It's really easy to apply and it doesn't come off, doesn't get smudged. And second, you do need a curler and do mascara. The reason why you need to do that because
you do need some support to hold the falsy lashes. It's almost like building a house. You need a foundation to hold it up to stay nicely. I used to have almost like 0 lashes, and I've been constantly using lash serums for 2 years, and I noticed a huge improvement.
Probably not a lot of people notice it, but it's almost like my own satisfaction.
It's a genetic. If you're born with not so much lashes, then you can't expect like it's gonna change completely different person.
But it really benefiting fuller lashes and slightly longer.
And this mascara is from Bagel. This is perfect for people who have lash extensions on.
Not cold water, no oil. You don't have to remove it with the makeup remover. It just comes with the warm water.
And the best part about this, it doesn't get smudged at all. Guarantee you, no smudge.
100%.
And you have to let it dry a little bit.
And then do it again.
This is the foundation that you're building. So stronger foundation you have, sturdy, the falsy lashes is gonna sit on.
So lucky for you, if you have really healthy lashes, just my lashes are very genetic and Asian lashes, so I have no complaint.
I'm born with it and I own it. Okay, first let's go start with the dramatic. And this is really fun because it's magnetic lashes. And I was so wondered about how does magnetic lashes work. What I'm gonna do, this is magnetic eyeliner. Completely dry. Okay, that means magnetic eyeliner, I put so little that it didn't work. So I'm gonna apply more eyeliner. This eyeliner is very bold and black, smooth. Never actually tried this kind of dramatic lashes on my eyes.
Wow, it's actually really good. Okay, as you see,
it's pretty good. My corner area doesn't collaborate really nicely. Just keep comes off. Yes, it does keep coming off. So if you see, it's off right here, this area. I'm gonna cut this into up to here. This side is shorter and this side longer. So always try to find a shorter one at the corner and the longer one at the end. So that way it makes your eyes elongate and it gives you cat eyes. Very sexy.
Okay, that's it. What do you think? I'm so not used to this. Oh my god, this is not... Okay, why is not working?
You do need a lot of amount of magnetic eyeliner. So I used a lot in here and I didn't use much on here. So it shows, comes off.
This is really life-changing. So, do you guys like it? Everyone has this non-symmetric eye shape. So this is more rounder and this is more elongate. In this case, you should trim this out. And you have to trim it like more vertical. Okay, that's better. It looks a lot more symmetric. Yeah. But to be honest,
more for the natural look. So this one,
and it's so easy. Just apply this here. Then just keep it right here. Ta-da! Okay, so second. Lashes, dramatic and very full volume.
I know exactly what I'm gonna look like with this.
I guess you need to balance it out, the top and bottom. So I'm gonna make it. Make it almond eye. Beauty of makeup. I don't have almond eye, but I can make it. This is so funny. Okay. I'm not a fan of this at all. What do you guys think? But I have some other ways, so I'm gonna share with you my real tips and tricks right now. So let's take it off, right? You saw it? Oh my gosh. Okay, so my real tip here. I cut them in half, like this. And I'm gonna switch it to the opposite side and then apply only at the tail. If you have a stubby round eyes, if you cover the corner at the end, that makes it even more stubby. So make sure you open the at the end and the corner all the time. Okay, that's it. What do you guys think? So much better, right? And if you find it's so awkward to leaving it just like huge gap in between, you have another one right here, right? So cut them small pieces.
At the end, cut them to make sure to look clean.
This is what Asian celebrities do. They cut it into very smaller pieces and apply them. And another tip I'm sharing with you. So I apply these lashes on top of the lashes, but you see this eye, when you touch it, there's eyeballs are sticking out the middle part the most. So what that means, when you apply on top, it's gonna be look very fake and noticeable. So I like to apply underneath the lashes, so it doesn't show anything at the corner. So this just blends well itself. And the key here is you are putting the glue on top of the lashes, not the bottom. This mirror, so good. I got this from IKEA for $6. I don't remember. But it's super cheap. It's very good for applying lashes and do makeup. Okay. This is my max overboard. I can't use whole falsies, so which is good for me because I actually saving a lot of falsies like this way.
next time you're using it, you feel like you're using the brand new one.
Place it. Yola, that's a lot, right? You're saving so much money. See, small eyes is not a bad thing. The wispy one. Just pour the glue a little bit on your thumb. I know exactly what I'm gonna say. I'm gonna feel like I'm gonna hate it. This is a very popular lashes in these days. It's mink lashes. I never tried whole falsies like this, and I'm quite happy with it. But the downside of it, it's very messy. Like if you actually come closer and take a look at it, it's like furs all over. Do you see it? But people don't come closer to you and then see, just check out your lashes. I guess it's not a big of a deal, as long as it looks natural.
But I'm cutting out part of it because it's gonna bother me once I'm applying it. If it's in my way, I cut them out.
Okay, so this is 5D. Lashes, which means it's a lot. It's very full, wispy. I like it from the far. I think I'll be very photogenic with these lashes. When you come closer, really depends on what's the occasion. If it's really dark and you're going out for a party, I think this will be perfect. But if you are going out on public that there's a sunlight and it's very bright side, and I don't recommend it. But yeah, I don't mind applying this. Short, still volume and fluffy. Whatever something sticks out, cut it. So what do you guys think? I feel comfortable with this. The length here is short, but also the sideways is quite short. My short stubby eyes, like mine, is perfect. Okay, let's take it off. So the last one, this is my go-to. And it looks very classic and nothing so special. That's the point. I don't wanna look I've got things done. I look natural, and people questioning like, she has a long lashes, is it real or fake? I can't tell, but anyway, she looks good. That's what I wanna hear. So this is my daily thing. I cut them in half like this. The longer size needs to go to the tail. If you are looking for a dull eye, like round eyes, then do this one in the middle, but I want to elongate my eye shape because it's round and I look innocent, but I do want to kind of look sexy and sophisticated.
That's it. It almost looks like you haven't got them done anything, but when you go to the sideways, it looks a little long.
And it makes your eyes a little bit longer. That's all I want. I get lash extensions all the time. And when I get my lash extensions done, and after 3 weeks later, I'm too busy that I can't get fill, then I use this trick to blend it out with actual lash extension and falsies, and it looks so natural. And nobody assumed that I got lash extension or falsies.
You know what though? My best is actually the magnetic lashes. It's really, really cool.
So this is it. I tried 5 different types of falsy lashes, and I picked this one. This is the 4th one. Have wispy volume, shorter width and shorter length. So it goes around with my eye shape so well. And usually never pick something like this, but I'm so glad that I actually tried, found something that's suitable for me. So I hope you guys do the same thing. So I will see you guys very soon. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you guys next week.